Welcome back. And now I am proud to introduce from our special, we talk about education, and you've got to have things to bring to the table if you want a job or a career. And you're here to help these people, and I'm so glad, from Greenville Tech. And I want to introduce Leslie Trant, who is Dean of Corporate and Career Development. I want to be sure I have that right, because it sounds very important. And next to her is Steve Hand, and Steve is the director for the Quick Jobs Program. Wow, you all are busy people. And here we have a whole new beginning, a new year. People need to get ready to make their lives better and their opportunities better, and that's what you do.
That's exactly right. The Quick Jobs Program was developed to help people get quickly back on their feet, either new skills, new occupation, and we can do that very quickly from 3 nights, 3 weeks, 3 months, and all kinds of hands-on training.
Okay, but you're helping people who already have some ability and some have been in the workforce, and they need kind of upgrade and maybe give themselves a boost to have, do something beyond what they already have been doing.
Correct.
Is that right?
These are adults. Our average age is mid-40s. These are adults. Most have worked, obviously, but some have been home with the children for years. Some have been become unemployed. They've had to change careers. The world is changing. New skill sets are needed. And if you get those new skill sets and credentials, then you become employed and you move on to a much brighter future.
Okay. And tell me, what about your situation? What are you?
Well, Steve and I started working on Quick Jobs with the Future at the same time. And our first focus was the healthcare arena. So there were a lot of opportunities for people to take training that could get them a job in the hospital or doctor's office pretty quickly, like become a medical receptionist. They could, perhaps they were laid off from a textile plant and worked in the office. Well, they can take those same skills and build with some healthcare training and terminology, operations, and get a job in a doctor's office. So we continue to build that, and then we changed and added into our offerings manufacturing quick jobs. And that's because primarily when BMW came in, all the suppliers started coming in. Now we have Boeing coming in. And there's so many opportunities for the workforce to grow. And we, of course, want them to continue to be here. And now we're moving into IT. That's our newest launch. January, we started launching careers in IT.
The growth is just tremendous. And
that's
the opportunities for the future.
That's right. And it doesn't take a 2 or 4 year degree for these jobs. Our students are getting good employment, and then they can continue to grow once they get the jobs.
And you can fit this in. You don't have to go at a certain time. I mean, you work with people who are already employed.
Yes,
and they may need to come at night or at different hours.
We have different offerings. Some of them might take 3 months to get through. Some might be done in a month, but we offer them throughout the year. So they don't have to wait for every January and every August to start. We have quick starts that keep them moving, and we do offer some online even. So that can even speed it up for them.
So right now, if somebody's out there and they're interested in better jobs and learning new skills, mm-hmm. they don't have to wait. You can pick up the phone and there'll be an opportunity because it's ongoing.
And we talk to the students, Steve and I both, and some of our other staff talk to the students anytime they want to come in. They can call, we can explain different options, we can even give them some assessments if they're interested. They don't quite know what direction to go. But we have, even our teachers will sit and talk to students. And we do that every day, all throughout the year. So they don't have to wait for a certain time or a certain appointment.
We have an open house every mm-hmm. month, the second Tuesday of the month.
You do?
In the Buck Mickle Center across from McAllister.
You mean anybody can go?
Anybody can come. It's mm-hmm. open to the public.
You don't have to be a student.
They can go online the website and pre-register, but they can come to figure out what they want to be when they grow up, so to speak. And they can arrange their babysitters. They can arrange their transportation to come to us. Then we help them plan their future, what they're interested in, what their aptitude is. We've had people that come from various agencies. I had a gentleman who resides at the rescue mission who just mm-hmm. finished one of our skilled trade training course is called the Computerized Numerical Control, CNC Machine Operator, and it took 18 weeks. Now he is gainfully employed. He had a bump in the road in his life. The rescue mission folks brought him to us for his training. We helped coordinate the employment. Now he is prepared for a very bright future. He's getting ready to take phase 2 of the training, too, in a few weeks.
So the opportunities are there.
They are.
And you think many people just don't know about it.
Nope. And that's part of our problem, is trying to get the word out. The state doesn't allow us to advertise a lot, but we try to get the word out through friends, family, churches, and whoever, and we appreciate this opportunity.
Well, that's what we're trying to do
exactly.
here.
Exactly. So hopefully somebody will tell their neighbor about, like, solar technology. We have new training in solar technology. You know, I'm a grandfather, so the thing about with coal and gas and oil.
And this is a whole new world.
It's a whole new world.
There.
Just think about the opportunities of people getting on ground floor. If they want to change careers, that might be something good to do. Or if they've been staying home helping an elderly parent, maybe be a nursing assistant. That's one of very, very popular programs, too. So we have a wide diversity. It's easy. You can day, nights. We even have a few on weekends and online. So it all simulates the real world, and you get a certification at the end.
So you try to work with people to fit their needs and their schedule.
Right, to meet what the businesses need. And there are some people that are called incumbent workers that work at businesses as part of workforce development, and we upgrade their skills while they're still working, or others are trying to get into those jobs. So we're working with people at all different levels, even some professionals that need that certification, like Black Belt and Lean Six Sigma training, which is high-level training. We do all that.
Steve and I enjoy our jobs because we've seen so many good stories, success stories of the individuals. We get down on the individual level. We hear about, you know, what they've gone through, and then we direct them, and we see them, as Steve mentioned, the individual that was homeless and ended up with a job.
So
now
you actually meet with these
yes,
people.
Yes, we talk
it
to
isn't
them.
Just somebody that they call.
Right.
You actually sit
we
down
work
and
with
care
them and
enough
hear
to
their, we
talk
hear
to
their
them.
Stories. And, you know, we look at our jobs are to make good things happen for other people. I mean, we really enjoy that, to see that good things are happening to other mm-hmm. people. It's rewarding to us, but more importantly, it makes a difference for that individual and our community as well.
Well, you must see the needs that are there, not only from the community standpoint, businesses, what they need, but from the people who come to you, what their needs
yes.
are.
Well, let me give you an example. This week, I'm meeting with a company because we've uncovered a big need in our area for material handlers. That's people that are skilled with using the forklift in the logistics, part of the supply chain we talk about. Well, there's a huge gap, and we have more and more companies coming in with warehousing needs. And this is something you have to have computer skills for now. The forklifts are computerized.
Life has gotten
inventory
more
control is.
Yeah.
So they need extra training. And so we're now planning our next program, which probably in the next maybe 6 months we'll have that going. And so that's what we do. We listen to these companies and say, okay, we can help you. You've got a need, tell us, and let us develop the program for you.
And we already have a forklift class that's offered every month. It's just 3 nights. So we add other components and then certifications, once again, those credentials. Because businesses want us to make sure that the people we're preparing meet their needs.
Now, we have a phone number, and it's 864-250-8800. Now, if you are watching, or maybe you know someone who could use some of this information, call that number, because there are opportunities out there waiting for people. And if you want a good income, you want a bright future, and this isn't just a certain age group.
No.
I mean, if somebody maybe has worked already, and then they've taken time off for whatever reason,
exactly.
to care for children or to care for an aging parent, and now all of a sudden they have time and they want to go back. They've got to get sharp again.
That's right.
Well,
right?
we make
That's
it
right.
easy. Come see us at an open house. Get our new catalog that we gave you there. It's all one catalog. It's beautifully designed. And they can sit down at one time and review everything. And then contact us and we'll help.
Corporate and career development. Here it is. Now, these are free. These aren't they?
That's correct.
Where can people get one of these?
Come to the Buck Mickle Center. Or call that 250-8800 number, or go online and register, and we'll send them to you.
All right. Okay. And this has all the listing. It's a tremendous catalog, and there's something there that would fit almost any need. You do a great job here in the Upstate, and you've filled already unbelievable amounts of need that
thousands and thousands
for people, both the employer and those who need employment.
Yes, ma'am.
And you're not limited to a certain age. You're not looking for somebody that's just out of high school. You can look for middle-aged people or whatever,
these
right?
These are adults in occupational transition. Doesn't matter whether you live in Greenville County or Oconee or Pickens County. People come to us. But go to your local tech school if you're outside Greenville County. But we help mostly Greenville County. But we'll help anybody. You just come to us and let's figure out how we can help
you. So even
you.
If you're not right in Greenville County, you're not going to close the door?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
So you work with people from other areas?
Other parts of the state. We have an RN refresher class, that one of the only ones in the whole state.
Oh, really?
We have people coming from all over. I have a lady I talked to on the phone whose husband's a veteran, and I talked to her. She was in Germany. They just moved to South Carolina, to Sumter. She will be coming here in about 3 weeks to take the RN refresher class so she can be recertified and work in the civilian world as a nurse.
Because she already is a nurse.
Already, but her credentials lapsed, so.
That's fabulous.
So we work with a lot of different ages. Particularly with the RN refresher, we have the nurses that have stayed home with their children.
Sure.
They've gone off to college now. So, you know, they might be in their 50s, 60s, and they want to refresh their skills, work full-time, part-time. So we help them with that. We do the hands-on practice, which they're most nervous about, and the review of the book learning. We review that with them online so they can do that at their home. And then they come in and we help them refresh their skills.
Well, we appreciate that you took the time to come and
share
and hope this information and will help somebody out there. And I have the number here if you didn't get it, but it's 864-250-8800. And we can all move forward and more positive lives. Thank you for what you
do,
both of you.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much.
Greenville Tech. It's a great,
great
thing that we have right here in our midst.
Thank
and wherever you are, if you have children out there, pick up a book and read to them. We'll see you next time.